It's Friday and it's time for your weekly UAS news updates, and this is week 60. This week, the news is a little bit boring, quite frankly, except for one drone release. So I'm going to keep it kind of short this week. I don't want to drone on and on and on for 30 minutes telling you nothing. So the first thing is Skydio announces a new drone, which is kind of exciting. We have an expanded network, delivery network from UPS and Matternet from that relationship here. We're going to talk about LAANC authorization. There's been a big spike in LAANC authorization, which is good news. And then lastly, I'll just talk a little bit about Pilot Institute, get an update for you guys. So let's get to it. First thing this week is a new drone from Skydio. Skydio, you know them with the R1, with the Skydio 2. They were in the news not too long ago. And now they're coming out with a commercial drone. That commercial drone is going to be called the X2. There's going to be two different formats. There's going to be an X2D and an X2E. And they've announced other things as well. I'll talk about this at the end. But the X2D is going to be designed for the US Army. It's more of a recon type of drone, so not something that you may get for yourself. The X2E is going to be designed for first responders and for enterprise operators. It comes with a 360-degree camera and a FLIR system. Now, the FLIR is not the highest quality. It's 320 by 256, so not designed to do you high-end type of thermal work. But it's got a 12-megapixel photo, a 35-minute flight time, and a 6.2-mile range. So that's about 10 kilometers right here. The drone itself comes with a variety of different software. They have a pretty big list if you want to go on their website and take a look. They have something for 360 zooming. Now, this camera is a 360 camera, so you can use this software to actually zoom into a specific area and kind of see what's going on, which is pretty cool, especially if you're going to do recon. Again, this is really good for the Army. It has the ability to do 180-degree vertical images. So at the top like this, you'll be able to do a full inspection, for example, of maybe bridges or things like that. It has a scanning software, so you can do house scanning, building scanning. So just a whole collection of different things. The drone is expected to be released on the fourth quarter of 2020. So that's kind of around the corner towards the end of the year. They also, at the same time, raised $100 million for development of their drones and for marketing efforts. So a lot of money going into their pocket at the moment. And hopefully we see some competition. Competition is always good. So Skydio in the news this week. The next thing I want to talk about is UPS Flight Forward. And UPS Flight Forward, I've talked about them before doing deliveries. I know deliveries can have a bad reputation right now because remote ID is being kind of blamed on them. I think it's a partial blame, quite frankly. I think there's a lot of other players that are pushing for bad remote ID. Remote ID could be good, but the way that it's been portrayed recently is not really the best response, I think. But anyway, I'm getting off. UPS Flight Forward, they're working with Matternet, and they have this Matternet M2 drone, which is doing deliveries. And they've been doing this for a while. They actually got 2,200 deliveries done to date, which is 4,400 flights, which is pretty cool. And they, in this case, they are expanding their network. This is happening in North Carolina in West Forest Baptist Health Hospital. And they're going to be carrying patient-specific medication. And this is time-sensitive, temperature-sensitive medication that needs to go into the customer. And so this is a great use for drone. They were saying that this has a very short shelf life, and they can get the medication to the patient in just a few minutes, which is great. So they're also going to be using it to deliver PPE to medical professionals, which is also a great application. There is a really cool video on their website. They have this station, and the station, you can see that the doctor comes in, they have a badge, and they open up the door and they put the package in there. And then as soon as they close the door, then the top of it kind of opens up like a flower, if you want. And then the drone flies out to its destination. It's all autonomous. So unfortunately, if you're looking to get a job there, not going to happen. But then the thing lands, and then the other doctor on the other side just comes up, picks up the package, and then they have the medication. So a really cool concept, quite frankly. I think this is a great application for drone delivery. Rather than delivering your hot taco or your tube sock from Amazon, and nothing against Amazon, but so this is kind of a good application. Next thing is some news on LAANC authorization. The CEO and the co-founder of Kittyhawk, John Igrans, I hope I'm saying his name right, said that LAANC authorization have been hitting an all-time high. He said that there has been 320,000 LAANC authorizations made in the country since the start of LAANC, which was back in 2017. And in the last 21 months, there has been more authorization in the last 6 months than there has been in the last 21 months. As a matter of fact, they said that a third of all LAANC authorizations happen in the last 6 months of 2020 than they did since the beginning. So one third of all the authorization happened in the first 6 months of 2020. I think it's pretty impressive. What this is telling me is not necessarily that there's more drone flights, even though I'm sure there are, but it's telling me that more and more people are realizing that they can use LAANC. And I'm happy about this because this is something that we've been trying to educate people about on Pilot Institute. And I'm happy that some of our efforts and other people's efforts of trying to tell people and educate people, you can use LAANC, please go ahead and do it. It's quick and it's easy. And so this is my message to you. If you're somewhat new to the drone world, you can submit an authorization to fly in controlled airspace using LAANC. You can use Kittyhawk right here. This is what I personally use. And it's very simple and it's very quick. And it makes you legal to fly in that airspace. So anyway, the last thing I want to talk about is Pilot Institute. Now, this video is available as a podcast on your favorite podcast, on Apple Podcasts and all the other places where you can get podcasts. So if you want to listen to this in your car or on your way to work, whatever, as you do laundry or whatever it is, and not see my face, which is always a plus, then you can do this by just listening. So that's all I have for this week. As always, please like, subscribe. Next week, we will have 5,000 followers, which I'm really excited about. This is a big point for us. And that's all I have. You have a great week, and I'll see you next week.